Welcome back, my wonderful people. This is a follow-up video to the last one I did on Monday. And I promised you guys on Thursday that I'll do a follow-up video concerning the analysis I did on the four currency pair. Now, I will start from, I'll start with the US dollar index. 1 minute. I'll start with the US dollar index, and this is 1 hour time frame. Now, if you look at this currency pair, this instrument is critically. Let me start from daily time or weekly. Weekly is better. Okay. If you look at this market instrument, we are at a very critical point where the market will decide whether US dollar index will either be bullish, look at it from here, or will be bearish. And if it's bearish, I'm proposing that this market will limit itself at 80.50. That is somewhere here. Let me get this line. 80.50 should be around here. Yeah, should be around 80.60/80.50. But I'm limiting my this thing around this level technically based on the technical time frame. If you follow that, that's okay. It's 80.65. Okay. This, if the market decide to turn down on the bearish side, I believe that this bearish market will be limited at 80.65. And if you decide to move this in upwards, I believe that this market will go as far as 80.50. I mean, 81.50 to 82.00. Okay, let's go to daily charts. I think we will get it better there. We'll get the picture clearer. I'm just taking my time to teach you this. Yeah, this is it on daily chart. This is it on daily chart. And like I told you earlier on, that this line in particular is a major support, resistance level that the market is either deciding whether to go break this line or they want to sell this US dollar index beneath this range, and the take profit, like I told you guys earlier on, should be somewhere here, 80.65. If you go to, let me not use 1 hour, let's use 30 minutes time frame. I believe we'll get the picture. Look at what is happening here. I think the time is around 1 minute. Let me check the time. The time now is 1:50 a.m. in the morning. There is this Nigerian time, and we are expecting this market to see if it will get to this level. That is around 81.29 before it starts falling again. If you watch throughout this week, the market has been trading, US dollar index has been trading sideways throughout this week. When it gets to this level, it falls back again. When it gets to this level, that's it. This is around 81.37. It started falling again. And let me minimize this graph for you to see what is really happening. I think 1 hour should be better. Okay, look at it. So it has been kind of trading within this range. Let me use this right hand button. This will be better for me. US dollar index has been trading within this range throughout this week. Let's see if it is going to break this region. Let me expand it more. Let's see if it's going to break this region by European session. This like I said earlier on, this is 1:50 a.m. in the morning. This is Nigerian time. Let's see if it's going to break this region before it starts falling back again. Or rather, touch this line before it starts falling back again. But I strongly believe that this currency pair may fall down. This market instrument may fall, but I don't want to just rush in and start selling US dollar for now. Let me wait for it throughout this week, because today being Thursday, the market is going to be very, very busy for us. A lot of numbers are coming out from the European side that will go a long way to determine the market direction for this market instrument, this particular US dollar index. So that is it for US dollar index. Let's go over to currency pairs. This week has not been really, really favorable to me, although I may have made some few pips, but my account is still in minus. Look at it. That's -$6. So I'm just waiting because I'm trying to look if this market will move in my favor. Let me see if the bullish trend will continue. And like I said earlier on, the maximum for my bull, if the bull should start on Euro USD, is around 1.3655. Okay, that's my maximum for the bulls, 1.3655. This should be around here. Okay, so if the massive fall should commence on US dollar index, so I will limit my bullish share first of all at 1.3655. So, but that being said, I'm not going to rush in closing this market. Let me just follow the market. Let me see how the fundamental analysis will turn out to be today. That will determine if I'm still going to hold this trade. If not, I'll close it, and I don't mind if it is -$26. I'll close it and re-enter a fresh trade in line with the trend. And like I said earlier on, let's wait and see if US dollar index will start a bearish trend, possibly today or tomorrow. Because the way I'm looking at whatever that is going to happen on that with that particular market instrument is going to take us into next week. If it is going to be bearish, that means we'll be buying Euro USD into next week. If US dollar index is going to be bullish, that's we'll continue selling Euro USD into next week. So the fundamentals tomorrow will be very, very important for us. And let's see this market behavior on another time frame. This is 4 hours index. Yeah, I mean 4 hours time frame. And from what is going on here, we've just seen the bulls picking up gradually. If you watch the trend on 4 hours in this thing, 4 hours time frame, the currency pair has been rejecting this level for quite a long time throughout from Monday, and we are now in Thursday. The market has been rejecting this level for a very long time. Let's see if it is going to make a push up And you already see I put my take profit here on the bullish side. And this was where I entered the trade already, thinking that the market will push up to this level. So let's see if it's gonna make a turn back and start the bulls, and let's see if we hit our take profit hopefully today and tomorrow. If not, if the market report today, the fundamental analysis today is favoring euro, and the market reacts in favor of euro, that means we are on the right track. Then if the fundamental analysis comes out negative and market starts selling this currency pair, that means I have to close my losses and enter a fresh trade in line with this. So that's one thing with forex trading. We are not, you should not be afraid to accept your losses. Okay. Once you hit the loss, you accept it and make the correction. Let your next trade correct the losses. So that is it for Euro USD. GBP USD. GBP USD surprised a lot of people yesterday. It really shook the entire market. So already, as if I knew what was going on. You know, last time I told you guys that let's see if it's gonna touch this line before it starts falling. So fortunately and unfortunately for me, I was not around when this spike happened. So it touched this trend and went upwards. Let's see how the market is going to react, whether the market will start selling from here. But for now, like I said earlier on, ever since this year, I've had a mixed feeling about GBP USD. So I'm very, very cautious about my trade with GBP USD, because I could remember in the first video that I told you guys that this area is a no man's land. Anything can happen. And look at it. Let me go to weekly charts. I think the weekly chart will. Let me minimize it. I told you, look at it, that this area is a no man's land. Anything can happen. So, and exactly as I predicted, that's what is happening. So putting a buy or sell here is very, very predictive. I mean, it's very, very risky. And also, your market might linger on for a very long time, might stop you from placing other trade that you want to place. So ever since the beginning of this year, from January 2nd, I resumed my trading this year. I always told you guys that this place is a no man's land, that we should be careful. And it is just like a deja vu. The market is just playing out the prediction. Who would believe that GBP USD will break this range after the job report that came out on Wednesday? And that was spike up to, this is about 110 pips from here. Okay, so we have to be very, very careful with this currency pair. That's my take on this. Then the next currency pair that we should be looking at is Euro yen. Euro yen, I'm still neutral about this currency pair. Seriously speaking, I didn't enter any trade in this currency pair throughout this week. It's just on my list. So let's see what happens, if it's gonna break this yellow line. Okay, and if it breaks this yellow line, let's see if it's gonna move up to this level, 142.7. Okay, so for me, I'm still neutral in this currency pair. Okay, it's still on my list. I'm still monitoring it. Okay, so the next will be GBP, I mean pound yen. Just give me 1 minute. On pound yen, exactly the same thing that happened with pound dollar also took place here. You know, I was expecting this currency pair to go down, And when I came back from a job I attended in my office, and I discovered that it has spiked back to where it was from the beginning of this month. So let's see if it is going to calm down a little bit. Like I told you guys on pound dollar that between pound yen and pound dollar, I have always had my mixed feelings concerning this currency pair, these two currency pairs. So, but pound yen has a very, very unique factor here. Unlike GBP USD, that it's in a no man's land, it's very, very obvious that pound yen, it's 100% bullish. Okay, it's quite bullish. So if you ask me between pound yen and pound dollar, which am I more confident to trade, I will confidently go for pound yen. Okay, pound yen, I normally use pound yen to augment my trade concerning pound dollar. But meanwhile, let me make a very, very strong sorry, let me expand it more. Be not quick to really consider this as a bullish candle, okay? Although there are more bullish potentials in pound yen, but I want you guys to take notice of what is happening on relative strong index indicator. It's now in overbuy area, so we're expecting this to start falling, as in pound yen. I'm expecting it to start falling. Let me minimize it a little bit. So although pound yen, it's 100% bullish, if you go to 4 hours chart, you will see what I'm telling you. Or let's go to 1 hour chart, a 1 hour time frame. You discover that it touched the 75% line and started falling again. So it's very, very important you take note of this, except if you're if you're a long term trader, okay? Although there are still potentials that this pound dollar will still cross the 75% mark, okay? So if you ask me, on long term, I will support a bullish view, but in the medium term, I will support a sideways trading. So if you ask me what to do, I will advise, if you have the enough capital to carry it, I will advise you to enter a bullish trade here. Otherwise, I'll ask you to watch the market patiently. Let's go to 30 minutes chart. I think we'll get a clearer picture there. Okay, 30 minutes chart is telling us a kind of bullish or neutral view here, because already on 30 minutes time frame, it has touched the 50% mark on RSI in this indicator. So for pound yen, I will remain neutral in this currency pair. Let me see what happened by tomorrow, but obviously is a very strong bullish is a very strong bullish market here, so to speak. If you ask me, for pound yen, it's a strong bullish market. This is because the major trade line here, it has already broken it. So we are looking at it. So the next target for pound yen is 177. Oh, no, 177 is too much. The next target should be around 175.67, okay, or 175.65. If you go to the monthly chart, you will see it. Okay, so I think the next target should be here. I think 172 is okay. 173, no, 175 should be okay. I won't go 177. 175 should be okay. So that is it for pound yen. Pound yen, I remain bullish, although in the meantime, the market is neutral. Euro yen, I will cautiously remain bullish. Let me see is a bullish move already, although the market is neutral now. I think if you are taking your profits on euro yen, the first take profit should be around here 142.00, and the second take profit should be around here 142.39. Okay, so I remain bullish, mildly bullish for euro yen. GBP USD, wow. Okay. If you ask me, this is a no man's land and is a bit risky to enter any trade here. I'll remain neutral for GBP USD. Okay, then Euro USD. Wow, I strongly remain bullish, and I'm targeting my maximum target for this bullish correction, although people are predicting that it will hit up to 1.3700 or 1.3771, but the maximum I will go for this is 1.3655 for Euro USD. And there's also something I want to show you on this US dollar index, something very, very important. Let me just give me a minute. Okay, this is US dollar index, and I got email from a friend that US dollar index has formed a head and a shoulder pattern, and I believe this is what he was referring to. This is the first shoulder, sorry. And this is the second shoulder. Okay, so, and if that be the case, and he was telling me that the take profit should be from here. Okay, this is 81.38, and this is the first shoulder, and this is the second shoulder. Now let's use here, and this is 81.04. If you subtract this from this height, that will be around 0.34. Okay, so if you want to take your profit, place your take your profit, that will be 0.34 minus 81.4. That should be around 80.770. So you should be putting your take profit here. I'm just telling this is an analogy somebody just sent to me, and I want to tell you my feelings about the whole thing. And the okay, this is where you should put your take profits. I think that's exactly where we have our take profit already. Okay, let's say it's 80.7. Okay, to some extent, the guy might be true to put your take profit here, okay, because of this head and shoulder pattern. I just feel I should announce this news to you, okay, break it to you, but I'm not going by it for the meantime. I'm just trying to be cautious on what I'm doing. Obviously, this from the look of this, technically this is a typical head and shoulder pattern, but my mixed feeling is this is because this is on hourly chart. This head and shoulder pattern was not formed on a daily chart, but let's see how the market will react to this chart pattern during the European session today and the US session today. And while we are waiting for market reaction, we should also take a very strong cognizance of the what's it called, the fundamental analysis. So I just feel that I should give you should just break this news to you and also tell you my view about it. I think we need to go to the fundamental analysis to see what we have today. Like I told us today that we have a very busy week today. We will have a very busy day today. Already, we have the MI inflation expectation from US, this thing from Aussie, and the number is high from the previous. Let's see the effect of this on. And they say if actual is greater than forecast, it's good for currency. So, since the actual is greater than the previous, it's obviously good for the currency. So we should expect to see a mildly bullish action or mildly bullish spike on Australian dollar. Okay, we already have some reports coming out from China. The HSBC Flash Manufacturing PMI 49.6. This rather not good for Chinese. The CB leading index from China, okay, 0.4. And let's see the effect of this on currency. But if actual is good, is greater than forecast, good for currency. And this actual is less than this in the previous one. Is not good for it at all. So this is BOJ monthly report. We should be expecting that around 5 a.m. And we see a whole bunch of PMIs, manufacturing PMI, service PMI from France, Spanish unemployment rate, German flash manufacturing PMI, German flash service PMI, current account from Europe. This is very, very important. All these things are very, very important. Most especially the German flash manufacturing PMI. Okay, we also have a flash manufacturing PMI, an average flash for manufacturing PMI coming from Europe. We also have flash service PMI coming out from Europe. We have Fisher speaking today. And 10-year bond option for British pound is also out today. Okay, from the US session. Wow, unemployment claims. This is very, very important. So you see why I told you that. Look at it. See why I told you that we have a very busy day today. So I will get back to you. I mean, during US session today. It's from me to you. I wish you a happy and a successful trade this week. Thank you and remain blessed.